properties of adjoint and inverse. A into adjoint of A equal to adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I. Second, determinant of K into A equal to K to the power of N into determinant of A. A is invertible. Then A into A inverse equal to A inverse into A equal to I. A inverse whole inverse equal to A. Determinant of A not equal to 0. That is, A is non-singular. Then A inverse equal to 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A. If A is non-singular, that is, determinant of A not equal to 0 and AB equal to AC implies B equal to C. That is, cancellation property holds true only for a non-singular matrix. Next, inverse of transpose of A equal to transpose of inverse. That is, A transpose whole inverse equal to A inverse whole transpose, provided A is non-singular. Next, if A is non-singular and A is symmetric, then A inverse is also symmetric. If A and B are non-singular and a square matrices of the same order, then AB inverse exists and AB whole inverse equal to B inverse A inverse. I think one more also I have written. Inverse of a square matrix. Inverse of a square matrix, if it exists, it is always what?
Symmetric.
No, it is always unique. Inverse of a square matrix, if it exists, it is always unique. Now, let us add few more properties. A and B are non-singular square matrices of the same order. A and B are non-singular square matrices of the same order. Then adjoint of AB equal to, can you guess what should be this?
Adjoint of B
into adjoint of A. Adjoint of B into adjoint of A. This is very important. So when A and B are non-singular, adjoint of the product equal to product of the adjointed in the reverse order again here also. How to prove this? Use A inverse formula. What is adjoint of A you can write from this? A inverse into determinant of A, can you write? Adjoint of A can write as A inverse into determinant of A. That means adjoint of AB. What you can write from this? Determinant of AB into AB whole inverse, can you write? But the determinant of AB is same as determinant of A, determinant of B into AB whole inverse, B inverse, A inverse. And this you can regroup it as determinant of B into B inverse, determinant of A into A inverse. Determinant of B inverse is same as adjoint of B into adjoint of A. Can I write this as adjoint of A into adjoint of B also or not?
Yes.
Yes.
No, you cannot write unless they are commutative, because product of matrices is not always commutative. That is, you should not write this as adjoint of A into adjoint of B unless it is commutative. Next, A is non-singular, then adjoint of A transpose equal to adjoint of A whole transpose. If A is non-singular, that is determinant of A not equal to zero, then adjoint of A transpose equal to adjoint of A whole transpose. Try to prove. So remember that adjoint of A transpose is same as adjoint of A whole transpose. Next property. A is non-singular square matrix of order n. A is a non-singular square matrix of order n. Then determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A to the power of n minus 1 is very, very important property. Determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A to the power of n minus 1. A is non-singular, so determinant of A not equal to 0. And A into adjoint of A equal to determinant of A into I. Take determinant on both sides. So determinant of A into adjoint of A equal to determinant of A into I. Now, it is like determinant of product of two matrices is same as product of the determinants. That is determinant of A into determinant of adjoint of A equal to. Now, when I am taking constant outside from any matrix in the determinant, then you write the exponent as the order of the matrix, because here the order is n. So, and the determinant of A is a constant. When I take outside, it will be determinant of A to the power of n into determinant of I. And determinant of I is 1. And divide with determinant of A because it is not equal to 0. So, determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A to the power of n minus 1. So whenever you want to calculate determinant for any adjoint, so instead of calculating adjoint and determinant, you try to calculate this directly, determinant of A to the power of n minus 1. So it will be very helpful in the numerical problems. Next, A is a non-singular square matrix of order n. A is a non-singular square matrix of order n. Then adjoint of A equal to determinant of A to the power of n minus 2 into A. Adjoint of A equal to determinant of A to the power of n minus 2 into A. A into adjoint of A equal to determinant of A into I. We are replacing A with adjoint of A. That means it becomes now adjoint of A equal to determinant of adjoint of A into I. Multiply with A on both sides. So A into adjoint of A equal to adjoint of A equal to determinant of adjoint of A into I. But A into adjoint of A is same as determinant of A into I into adjoint of A equal to. The formula for determinant of adjoint of A is determinant of A to the power of n minus 1 into A. then you can conclude that adjoint of A equal to determinant of A to the power of n minus 2 into A. So in the numerical problem, if it is asked to find adjoint of A, so calculating adjoint of A, again for that adjoint of A, adjoint, it is very difficult. So if you remember this, determinant of A to the power of n minus 2 into A, then immediately you will get the answer. But remember, this is applicable only for n greater than or equal to 2. One more. A is a non-singular square matrix of order n. A is a non-singular square matrix of order n. Then, determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A to the power of n minus 1 whole square. Adjoint of A equal to determinant of A to the power of n minus 2 into A. This already we have proved. Now for this you take determinant on both sides. So determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A to the power of n minus 2 into A. Now determinant of A to the power of n minus 2 is a constant. When you are taking outside from this determinant, it will be determinant of A to the power of n minus 2 whole to the power of, what should I write? N. Because the order of A is N into determinant of A, which is same as determinant of A to the power of N into N minus 2 into determinant of A. That is determinant of A to the power of N square minus 2N plus 1, which is same as determinant of A to the power of N minus 1 whole square. Next, one more property. A is non-singular square matrix. Then, determinant of A inverse equal to 1 upon determinant of A. A is non-singular square matrix. Then, determinant of A inverse equal to 1 upon determinant of A. Can you identify which property you can use to prove this?
Sir, A into A inverse equal to I.
Good, correct. A into A inverse equal to I. Take determinant on both sides. So determinant of A into A inverse equal to determinant of I. So determinant of the product is same as what? Product of the determinant. So determinant of A inverse equal to 1. So determinant of A inverse equal to 1 upon determinant of A. So whenever you want to calculate determinant for the inverse, so instead of calculating inverse and then determinant, you calculate directly 1 upon determinant of A. A is a non-singular square matrix of order n. A is a non-singular square matrix of order n. Then, adjoint of K into A equal to K to the power of n minus 1 into adjoint of A. Adjoint of K equal to K to the power of N minus 1 into adjoint of A. So using A into adjoint of A equal determinant of A into I, replace A with KA and then simplify. Next. A and B are non-zero square matrices of the same order. A and B are non-zero square matrices of the same order, and product AB is zero matrix, then both A and B must be singular matrices. A and B are non-zero square matrices of the same order, and product AB is a zero matrix, then both A and B must be singular matrices. Assume that A is non-singular. Assume that A is non-singular implies A inverse exists. Now, AB equal to 0 implies A inverse into AB equal to A inverse 0. Now, apply associative property. A inverse A into B, A inverse into 0 will be 0. But A inverse A is I. So I into B is 0, which implies what? B equal to 0, which is a contradiction to the given condition. Contradiction to the given condition that B is non-zero. Hence, our assumption is wrong. But the assumption that we have taken is A is non-singular. Implies A must be singular. Now similarly, you can conclude that in the same manner, B also singular. You subtract both the equations, P cube equal to Q cube and P square Q equal to Q square P. Then P square is common, P minus Q, Q square is common, Q minus P, take left side. Then P minus Q into P square plus Q square equal to 0. Assume that P square plus Q square is non-singular, that is determinant not equal to 0. Hence inverse exists. So multiply with its inverse on both sides. Then I'll get P minus Q equal to 0, P equal to Q, which is a contradiction to the given condition that P not equal to Q. P equal to Q is wrong because it is given as P not equal to Q. Hence, determinant of P square plus Q square must be equal to 0.